Don't make home buying any more difficult than it needs to be. It's a competitive situation out there, but you don't have to settle. I've got some red flags that homebuyers need to look out for when they're looking for a home, because you don't want to just win and have the wrong home. You want to win the right home. It's no mystery that buying a house in recent months has been really difficult. You have low inventory, so there's not much to choose from. Prices are going up because of multiple offer situations, and people lose out on offers that they write sometimes, so buyers have gotten desperate. At the same time, some sellers have gotten a little sloppy and a little greedy. So there are some red flags out there that I think homebuyers should be looking at and making sure they're aware of when they see a house. The first red flag is a real simple one. It's cleanliness. If the house is a mess and you're going in there to see it for a showing, come on, people. Really, if you can't get the place ready for showing and have it be clean, that's a red flag for me, because it means they probably haven't maintained it well for years. The second red flag that I look for is drainage. The drainage of the home is obviously very important. You don't want water inside the house. So I'm looking for the pitch away from the home. And then the second thing that I'm looking for is the sump pump. Here in Minnesota, most of the homes have sump pumps. Some are very active, some are not. I'll look outside and see whether the grass is extra green out there behind where the sump pump is ejecting, or whether there's erosion there from an active sump pump, or even in some cases, we'll walk around and be walking through a swampy backyard because the sump pump is ejecting all the time. That's a red flag for me. The third red flag that I'm gonna talk about today, and I look at and every time I see a home, is the exterior condition of the home. If it is either not well cared for or just old, there are going to be costs that are associated with this. If you've got original wood windows from the 70s or 80s, they're probably going to need to be replaced in the near future, even if they've been maintained fairly well. And that can be costly. Some homes, $50,000 or $60,000 to replace all the windows and doors. A new roof can also be quite costly. You can look up what the age of the roof is, but we also want to look at what kind of condition the roof is in while we're on the property. Also good to look at is the deck. If there's a big back deck on the back of the home and it hasn't been well maintained, that's a lot of money. So I want my buyers to be aware of the cost that they're facing soon after they buy a home, not just the cost of the home. The fourth thing I really like to look for is the quality of the work done on the home. And let's talk specifically about renovations or flips. I see a lot of them that are kind of lipstick on a pig, if you know what I'm talking about. A flipper will come in and just do the basic stuff to the home, make it look pretty, put some nice jewelry on it, new fixtures, new counters, things like that. But they haven't fixed the underlying problems that may have existed. Once the home is flipped, you, the buyer, don't necessarily have the ability to go inside the walls and see what's going on. So there are some telltale signs of a quick or sloppy flip. One is the quality of the product they're installing in the home. The second is the quality of the workmanship. I'm looking for small gaps or large gaps in the woodworking. I'm looking at the installation of tile in bathrooms. There are plenty of telltale signs when a flip is not done properly. You want to have an inspector, a realtor, or a contractor, or all three, helping you understand the quality of the work on that house. Because once you buy it, there's not a lot of recourse that you have against that flipper. In this fast-moving market, buyers often don't have much time to make a decision. And sometimes they don't even have much time to look at the home. So while they're looking at the home and trying to figure out whether they love it and it's perfect for them, a good realtor is taking a look for those red flags that I talked about and making sure that they're not exposing their clients to more risk. And that's my take.